Welcome to this massive online open course, or MOOC, on climate change. I'm often asked why the World Bank Group, the world's biggest development institution, is concerned with climate change. Well, because, first, the science is crystal clear. 95% of climate scientists agree that human-influenced climate change is real, and that we have to do something about it, or the impacts are going to be severe for all of us. Second, we know that climate change in our lifetime threatens to roll back development gains we've made. Third, because if we don't confront climate change, we won't end poverty and we will struggle to build shared prosperity. The World Bank's first Turn Down the Heat report, on which much of this course is based, had an enormous impact, both externally to the bank and inside the bank group. The subtitle of that report was Why a 4-degree warmer world must be avoided. The 4 degrees Celsius scenarios that were presented were devastating. Unprecedented heat waves, droughts, superstorms, record-breaking floods. In a 4-degree world, or even in a 2-degree world, we're acutely aware that it is the poor who are the most vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. It is the poor who will be hit the first and hit hardest. Importantly, even at the current level of warming, 0.8 degrees Celsius, climate impacts are already being felt. Without urgent action, climate change threatens to grind millions of people back into extreme poverty, or worse, it will slam the lid on poverty reduction efforts for decades. At the World Bank Group, we refuse to let that happen. We are stepping up our mitigation, adaptation, and disaster risk and resilience management work. But the scale of the challenge before us is enormous. Therefore, we are focused on the least number of most important things that can have the greatest impact. For us, these are to get prices right, get finance flowing, and to work where it matters most. Building low-carbon, climate-resilient cities, moving forward on climate-smart agriculture, and working with others to accelerate energy efficiency and investment in renewables that can make a big difference. Putting a price on carbon and removing harmful fossil fuel subsidies are necessary steps towards directing investment to low-carbon growth as well. But tackling climate change is not an effort that governments can take on alone. We need a response that brings together governments, investors, the private sector, civil society, and individuals. Access to the latest relevant evidence-driven data is critical. Equally important is to make these materials accessible in a way that people who are not used to complex scientific language can use them to help make decisions. Decisions that enable each and every one of us, in whatever we do, wherever we are, to not lose sight of the possibility of not just avoiding doom, but of improving lives. It's easy to lose sight of the possibility of a better future when we're focused on droughts, heat waves, rising seas and superstorms. But if we use the evidence and opportunities before us wisely, the future can be brighter than the one that most people can envisage today. It takes knowledge to do this, and that is what this MOOC is all about. Thank you.